There are still challenges that we have to face. Awareness of the clinician that it's indeed possible to have this kind of testing. Awareness that there are those recommendations, so it's not a test without any actionability, but you can do something about it.
Even though that pharmacogenetic information can be found in the product specifics of the drugs, the insurance system is reluctant to pay for the analysis. Something very, very challenging circles around on the knowledge that physicians have of how to implement pharmacogenetics into their daily life. Educating physicians is the way to go. This is something that we need to do. However, it's way too slow for the implementation. The other thing that needs to be done is to make reports as obvious and easy to handle as possible.
The challenges that we will face in a country such as Qatar are no different from what you could find elsewhere. The physicians in Qatar are quite knowledgeable of the potential of the technologies. What I believe is a bit of a challenge is to be able to integrate these in the general practice, in the day-to-day practice. It is more a matter of actually conveying to the public that the tools are now available and the national health system can implement it.
I think it's very important to have an interaction, to learn from each other what are the challenges and also learn what are the solutions that were found in the different countries. We try to bring together people to exchange information. The whole idea is to present pharmacogenetics and pharmacogenomics in such a way that you're not overpromising, but also you will allow patients and clinicians to benefit from the potential that it really has.
Easy to use reporting is the most pragmatic and fastest way to implement pharmacogenetics.
The test is going to deliver the information about the drugs related to the illness of the patient, polypharmacy patients. That is where the complexity becomes too big to be handled in the short time and in an effective way. All that has also impact on the cost. And it's difficult. If the doctor gets a very nice report, he can read, he can understand, and can apply to that patient at that moment, then is the acceptance going to be very good. The most difficult thing will be the interpretation. And in this interpretation, we need to put efforts together, all scientific people, also the companies who are doing work on that, and get to a standardization. My company is in Germany, in Fürth. We began and worked with scientific papers. We are querying the information ourselves, and we went with this information to the doctors. We were not using the words doctors are using. We made the work to translate that from the scientific way to the doctor's language. And now our doctors are using that, and they are very happy.